What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. It's another day and yet another vehicle delivery. This time it's something very strange. I already took delivery of it yesterday, but what we're gonna do now, we're gonna head over to Stradman's house. We're gonna surprise him with it. I've got a little something in mind. It'll make a lot more sense once we actually get there and you know what's going on. So I'm gonna have Alex take the new secret vehicle over there. That means I need a vehicle. I'm gonna be taking the McLaren. I don't wanna give away any secrets, but this might be the last time you hear a cold start of this vehicle with a stock exhaust. I'll just leave it at that. It really does sound good this way. It's got the sport exhaust already. We're gonna do something just a little bit more crazy. It's actually a lot more crazy. Out, blue sky, green grass, in a McLaren. Do a quick little launch. This car is way too quick. I've been driving my Raptor too much lately. Now, I don't want to ruin the surprise, obviously, but I want to give you a little something to, I guess, set the tone. Let's just say you guys are definitely going to question why on earth I bought this vehicle. Let's just leave it at that. Not bad, but it could be much, much better. We'll address that very soon. All right, now here we are at the infamous house of Strat. All right, James, we're here, we're ready to go. Are you ready to see this?
I have absolutely no idea what it's gonna be, but I'm excited.
I wanna give you like maybe a little hint.
Okay.
You're definitely gonna wonder why I bought it.
Okay.
You're not gonna think it was a good idea.
Is it a cool car?
It was expensive.
Okay.
It cost a lot of money.
Like,
it costs, I paid $125.
Okay.
So not like super expensive.
Still,
like,
lost a lot of money.
It's a good chunk of change.
Okay.
I'm not going to lose money on it a lot, maybe, per se, hopefully.
He's not confident.
I mean, we'll find out. I'm definitely not confident in that. All right, Adrian, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Go ahead and pull it around.
This
exciting moment.
It feels like my birthday. It's not even my car.
It's a present. Just like, presents are always fun.
The anticipation. I'm trying to decide which way he's going to go.
Let's see. I think he's going to be coming around right here. Any moment now.
What have you done?
It's a little bit.
Oh.
Oh, what?
Okay.
That's not the right. wrong car.
It sounds nice.
You brought the wrong car. Let me call Alex. We'll have to have him come around the corner. Sorry, take two. Alex.
You can park in that second driveway.
Can you bring the actual vehicle around? Okay, here it comes. Here comes the real one. All right, James, are you ready for this?
I don't know what to believe anymore.
Yeah, this is looking a little bit staged, honestly, if I'm being fair. But there's something coming around this corner.
Is it a donk?
It's not a donk. I didn't pull a Stefan. Thank good. What?
What?
That's the same vehicle. What on earth? We got ourselves a proper Velociraptor, baby. The V8 swap, supercharger and all.
Wow.
Here she is.
That thing is sick, dude.
Yes.
Let's hear it. Can we hear it?
Yeah, give that a little rev.
I thought that little baby V6 sounded good.
That blow-up valve was cute.
Wow. That sounds so good.
It really does. They did a very good job.
It's an actual Velociraptor. You've been driving the knockoff for a while.
I know.
People have been giving
me flack. And it's like, okay, it's time to pony up. Go with the V8.
Oh, man, that's really good with the hood off.
You love to see it.
Dude, congratulations.
Thank you so very much. Yeah, moving on up in life, like baby steps.
I love how you got the exact same color.
It came up for auction on Cars and Vids, and
okay.
I was like, there's no way that I don't buy this vehicle. It's still got the sticker.
Oh, wow.
Here, the protective film here. It's got 1,000 miles on it.
Jeez, so how much did somebody spend on this and then to just
they
sell it?
They cost $150,000 from Hennessy.
Oh, okay.
I paid $125.
Oh, dude, that's a good deal in this market, too. Wow.
And I don't know, like maybe the dealership bought it and kind of used it a little bit here and there.
Okay, right, yeah.
I have no idea what the backstory is. Would love to figure that out, but Yeah, here it is.
In all of its glory. It's the same exact truck. This one is a 2020 versus a 2017. Oh, okay. So this has some of the new fancier, like, magnetic suspension,
Wait,
all of that.
Wait, has seen the truck yet?
No, not
this
at all.
This is their first time
too? They have not seen anything.
We're in this together.
Yes, yeah. So this is a brand new walk around. I don't even know how to operate my own vehicle. Boom. It's got reskinned seats with the red accents.
That's super sick.
And then, the Velociraptor plaque.
That is essential.
Very nice. Serial number, what is that? I can't read it from here, like 40-something.
I like that Velociraptor right there.
Yeah,
I didn't even see that.
Tennessee stitching. Velociraptor.
Yeah, that's sick. I hope you don't lose an upper control arm. Wait, what?
What?
Did that happen
what?
To somebody else with a raptor?
Oopsies. What? Oopsies. Yeah, that happened. I saw someone's
that's
Instagram
where my,
story.
That's where my raptor is
Very
right now.
Unfortunate.
Yeah, I lost an upper control arm. So don't be like me. It's an 18.
So maybe...
I was on a gravel road.
Maybe it's a problem that was fixed
it's
in this?
It's just a problem when you drive on gravel roads.
I see.
Upper control arms on gravel roads.
Yoinks.
Yeah.
Wouldn't be a proper Stradman video if we didn't get behind the
Especially
vehicle.
Especially in my neighborhood,
In
right?
your neighborhood.
So all the neighbors can
yes.
really enjoy the
yes,
sound
let's,
as well.
Let's...
Oh, man.
This is exactly how they should have come from Ford.
I know. This is the way God intended.
It is.
This is essentially a Raptor R.
Essentially,
it's got the 5.0
the
Coyote.
Raptor R, it is. Yeah.
So yeah. I figured the Raptor R is coming out next June. I really wanted one.
Right.
But like, the way vehicle production is lately, it's probably going to get delayed.
I'm sure it will be. Yeah.
And I did not get in early on like any sort of waiting list or anything
list.
Like
yeah,
that.
Yeah,
so
either.
I'm like, it's going to be. Two years at
minimum.
Least.
Probably more than
yeah,
that, though.
Yeah, easily, until I get one. Yeah. So I figured, why not get my own do-it-yourself Raptor R?
Yeah.
So here it is. One key difference I did forget to mention is this is actually a Raptor GTR. You can see because it has a badge on it. Alex slapped that on there one day. What? So we're going to have to get the GTR badge for the new Raptor as well.
No,
this is a one-of-one Raptor GTR. It's pretty sweet.
Honestly, if we just break the GT off.
There we go.
It looks like the R logo.
Raptor R.
If somebody wants to buy Patrick's Raptor, let him know. Because you're trying to sell this, right?
Hit the brother up. Hey, there you go.
There's a classified advertisement below.
I'll link to it in the description.
Yeah, if someone wants to buy it.
This is the one to have. I mean, that's the one that's really the one to have.
Right.
But if you don't want to pay an arm and a leg.
But if you don't want that one, you should get this
one. This is the next best thing.
Never abused.
Never abused. Never.
Never.
Literally.
Never driven in the mud.
I've never taken this off.
No winter tracks.
It's never been off pavement.
Right.
It's never been.
Never.
That's just wear and tear.
That's just normal wear and tear.
That's just regular wear and tear.
Never.
So yeah, if you're looking for a clean machine.
Always garaged by Alex.
Yeah.
Reflection intentions. Always detailed. Always baby.
Detailed daily.
Definitely,
don't
definitely
pay
no
attention to that.
The paint.
Definitely no Timberlines on there. Definitely
the
no.
These are the Patty Adair racing stripes.
Yeah, this is the Patty livery.
No, due to the Mac.
Yeah, we got to clean this thing up real nice. Get it looking its best. Give it a nice polish. Get it good as new. And then it'll be ready for a new home. We've got pretty much every type of Raptor who have ever existed.
Pretty much.
This kind of neighborhood.
Yeah.
We've got the V8 Velociraptor Supercharged. You've got the Shelby, is that 600? What is it called?
It's got a sticker on the
horsepower.
Side. It's got a sticker on the side that says 525.
So here's the thing. Raptor that's essentially stock but has an intercooler, haven't tuned it yet. It like, the Velociraptor V8's definitely a good bit quicker, but it kind of keeps up with it, especially doing like a freeway pull. I think your Shelby Raptor might have a fighting chance against the V8 Supercharged.
I'm down. Just don't have an upper control arm.
Yeah.
So as soon as I get that, let's race.
The drag race of the century. We're going to have...
Do it on the lake bed?
That'd be sick. That would be very cool. Because you can't have... You need that width.
Yeah.
There's nowhere other than like a freeway.
Spread out. Uh-huh.
Okay, lake bed.
Semi-safe.
We're going to have Raptors of all sorts.
Safe. Yeah, safety third.
If we have Nick with his Supercharger, here's the thing. That's a 6.2 liter V8.
Yeah.
Does that make that it? That's only a 5.0.
He's got 37s though.
He's got 37s on his?
Tires.
Okay, I've just got the 35s.
I got all the tires in the back. I
this
got a spare
gonna
tire
be
for everybody.
So interesting. Oh, that's very nice. That's really thoughtful,
welcome.
Actually.
You're welcome.
Like, oh, James, I got two flats. I need yours.
You bought a second Shelby?
I was going to truck through a control arm because it knew
I know,
stopping
it knew
you with four flats.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Ultimate Raptor drag race coming soon, maybe, hopefully.
Here it is, take it all in. Two beautiful babies straight out of Detroit. You love to see it.
And a Tesla.
And a Tesla.
Oh, so
oh man, looking great. That's another American vehicle.
Tesla.
If someone, hey, we'll do a little 2-for-1 deal.
Oh yeah, well yeah, oh yeah.
Buy the
Tesla
and my Raptor.
Yep.
James will take you to dinner in the Bugatti.
Yeah. Probably a pretty cheap dinner, like a McDonald's or something. But yeah, dinner.
Yeah.
Dinner.
Oh yeah.
It counts,
I mean, like,
count it.
It's dinner. If it's food, it's dinner.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And if it's the different car.
Right.
Don't hold me to that. Maybe not.
Wait,
the
what
Bugatti.
Are you gonna do? You gonna take him out to Ruth
I'm
Chris?
I'm gonna do nothing.
You're gonna take him out to Ruth Chris.
I'll take him to Ruth's Chris. I'll hold my end of this agreement. I'll take him to Ruth's Chris. You take him through the drive through.
Yes.
In
McDonald's.
A vehicle.
Yeah, McDonald's.
Hopefully
uh-huh.
a cooler vehicle than
oh,
the Tesla.
Oh no, yeah, we're not gonna do the Tesla. Because they'll own the Tesla.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah, it'd be their car at that point.
Yep.
Okay, deal.
All right, well, these are the vehicles. I think we need to go do a little bit of shenanigans on camera, kind of compare and contrast the two, get a little feel of the
purely
exhaust.
Purely for scientific reasons.
Purely just no, for scientific stuff.
Obviously.
Just for no you pleasure. Guys to get the data. It's all about the data.
Yep,
so, James,
data.
We're going to leave you be. We're going to let you go back to eating lunch in your Urus, which
That's
is what
right.
you're doing when I pulled up.
Pretty much.
I don't know why you do that. It's pretty weird. But thank you, James. We will see
yes,
you in the
congrats,
next one.
Dude. Yeah, see you soon.
All right, pulling out of James's house. Look at this view. This is so ridiculous. Both Raptors just going down the street. How funny is that? We got ourselves a little drag race opportunity. That was neck and neck. That sounds too good. We made it back home and yeah, it's official. I've got a Velociraptor VA. I'm really happy about this. These never ever like come up for sale. I've been looking for these ever since they started making them. And generally the people who bought these originally from Hennessy, they don't really need to sell them. They've got enough money. It's kind of like a ridiculous vehicle. If you own it, you've got enough money that you can keep it forever. So they don't really come up for sale very often. So when I saw this for sale and my favorite color and all the other specs were exactly what I liked, I knew I had to get it. So here it is in all of its glory, the V8 Velociraptor. But I'm not gonna end the video here. Before we're done here, I think we need to go do some exhaust comparison drive-bys. So we're gonna take the V6 out and the V8. We'll compare them head to head. The V6, now that it's got that blow-off valve mod, it sounds amazing. I love hearing that blow-off whistle, but there's just nothing like a good old-fashioned supercharged V8. Let's do it. All right, starting it off with the V6. I love that blow-off valve, and the V6, it honestly, the exhaust note on that, it sounds different from just a regular old car with a V6 engine in it. It's got kind of like an anger and a growl to it. It sounds actually like really nice, really refined, but it's definitely not the V8. Let's hear what that one sounds like. That thing is insane. I was trying so hard.
Oh, here we go, here we go.
That thing absolutely rips. Every time it drives by, I'm trying so hard not to make any noises or talk or say anything, just so you guys can get that full V8 experience the way it was intended. That thing just sounds so good. It's an absolute monster. I was saying the V6 Raptor, especially with the blow off, like it's got a cool, unique sound to it. I like it a lot, but there is absolutely nothing compared to that supercharged whine and that V8. All right, one final comparison. We've got them lined up head to head. You guys can be the judge. Let me know what you think in the comments. I think there was a clear winner to that. I'm so in love with this new truck. It's amazing. All right, I think that's gonna do it for this video. Check out this amazing lineup behind me. Does it get any better than that? You got two Raptors flanking the McLaren 720S. It's so cool. Stay tuned for more content. I've already got two mods on the way for the new V8 Velociraptor. One of them's coming from Boston, so stay tuned for that. It's gonna be coming very soon. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'll catch you in the next one.